thank you all for joining today's call. We have quite a few of you, and this is going to be a really great session. I'm really looking forward to it. So hi, and welcome to this Ignite webcast. And my name is Josh Topow, and I'm a program manager for Office 365. And Ignite events are a series of technical workshops for IT professionals and Microsoft partners. And these Ignite webcasts will address different technical subjects and scenarios that are really beneficial to anyone that wants to increase their knowledge of the Office 365 suite. So today we are really excited to have Mark Cashman leading our webcast. And Mark is a senior product manager on the SharePoint team. And he focuses primarily on SharePoint Online and SharePoint Mobility. Mark has also been at Microsoft since 2000, so he's very knowledgeable about the Office 365 suite and obviously SharePoint. So in today's webcast, Mark will be diving in and taking a comprehensive look at SkyDrive Pro. So today's session provides you a really great opportunity to hear directly from a Microsoft employee and learn about some of the new features and releases for Office 365. So today's webcast will be about an hour, and we'll leave a few minutes at the end of the call to field questions from anyone. And you can go ahead and type your questions into the link chat box during the presentation, and we'll try to get to all of them. But I'm going to ask that you probably hold those until the end when we have the Q&A, and then you'll have a better chance of getting your question answered. So if one last thing is that we are recording today's session, and we will make the deck available. Like Mark just said, he'll be tweeting it out, and I'll also be posting it on the original blog post, which you can find. Let me go ahead and paste that in. So you'll be able to find the video recording probably in a day or two, but you'll find the PowerPoint there later today. So that's it for me, and without further ado, Mark, whenever you're ready, take it away.
Definitely. Thank you, Josh, and thank you, everybody, for joining from around the world. It's always nice to get folks that are waking up and starting their day. Certainly, maybe some people are taking time out from lunch. And then for those of you that are a little bit further away, and some of you in the future, certainly that you're maybe staying after or carving out a little time at the end of your day, fully appreciate it, and hopefully make it a worthy 60 minutes because we're going to cover a lot. Got a few slides, got a lot of demo, and then if you stay around towards the end, I'm going to use SkyDrive Pro in a fun way to post a survey, which is really a contest, and I'll tell you a little bit more about that. But we'll be using SkyDrive Pro. I'll tweet out a little something so that you can take the survey that I create in SkyDrive Pro, and then we'll see where that goes. So hopefully that'll be fun. But what we're talking about today is SkyDrive Pro. I do want to make some clarifying statements just so we're all really clear on what SkyDrive Pro is, and I'll get to that in a second. But we are going to be covering everything from the native apps that we are now having in market, and I'll talk about those. I want to address really what our story is around the web, and that's really browser access to your SkyDrive Pro and how that gives us a lot of nice access from all your different devices, or for the variety of people bringing different devices. So that in your company you'll have a breadth of access to SkyDrive Pro. We want you only to be able to access it from anywhere, any device. And the oh my is just we're covering a lot, so we'll get started. Throughout the session, I've put out some tweets that'll go out automatically. If you want to go and check my Twitter feed or follow me, you'll get all that. Some of them are just pointers to a lot of great documentation and content, videos and stuff that we have out there. And certainly a lot of those resources I'll also put into the deck, so you'll have that in the downloadable version if you want to get it later. But if you check my Twitter feed, you'll see a number of things going on about the session, during the session, and certainly after it'll be there, all the links. So first, this is sort of the what is SkyDrive Pro. The way that we've built it and the way that we're continuing to innovate on it is we want it to be frictionless for the end user. This is the person who's going to log into their browser, access their files, create new files, work with other people and share. We want this to be easy. We want it to be accessible across any device and certainly anywhere, whether you're connected to the internet, you're online, or when you're offline. Certainly we want you to continue to have the best experience that we can provide on the device that you're using. So everything on the left-hand side is really that user-centric good experience, good access, and ease of productivity so that people can share what they're working on and get that feedback from other people. On the right-hand side, certainly the balance of any service that is selling to customers that, of course, want to keep their data protected, they want to enable sharing, or if they don't want to share, they want to be able to limit that. So there's the IT side, where the company or the business that you work for maybe has certain compliance needs and measures that will allow you to do certain things and certainly potentially disallow you in the way of keeping things more compliant in their requirements. But really the biggest thing that we offer is SharePoint and SkyDrive Pro offer enterprise-grade content management, and it doesn't stop or change or do anything different in SkyDrive Pro. It is still based on SharePoint, and you get all that goodness of very feature-rich content management in terms of versioning, in terms of sharing, in terms of review and approval type processes that you may set up. You can do all that from your SkyDrive Pro, or certainly if you're looking across the breadth of your company, how people are going to leverage that. You can take advantage of a lot of that good capabilities that have been there and are now available to the end user, while maintaining compliance and control. Control meaning, you know, whether you want to share, you can disable that or enable it. If you want people to have or not have the SkyDrive Pro folder to themselves, you can control that. And then, of course, security is really more the basis of the security that SharePoint offers, the security that you build on-premises if that's where you're consuming SkyDrive Pro, or if you're using Office 365, of course, we go to the nth degree when it comes to security to protect your data, and SkyDrive Pro in that environment is no different. In fact, it is exactly the same as a team document library when it comes to security. The only little difference is the end user has a little bit more control in who they give permissions to. So if we look at SkyDrive Pro as a place to store, sync, and share, certainly to work on and collaborate with Office documents, but certainly to store other types of documents, we hope it's a service that end users crave, and certainly we hope that organizations will endorse it and use it. So a few more slides just to kind of jump through the what is SkyDrive Pro. Some of these are to debunk a few myths, because we get a lot of frequently asked questions around SkyDrive Pro, and certainly we want to head those off and certainly address them in the best way that we can. So SkyDrive Pro is a part of SharePoint Online, which is a part of Office 365, and by default, that SkyDrive Pro folder will give you 7 gigabytes of personal quota that you as the individual, and certainly across an organization, if there were 500 people, each person, each of those 500 would get 7 gigs each in Office 365. SkyDrive Pro is also a feature. It's a part of SharePoint 2013. So if you're using SharePoint on premises or going to be soon upgrading to SharePoint 2013, then you would get SkyDrive Pro, certainly if your IT department and some of the requirements would allow you to have that SkyDrive Pro. It's more configurable in terms of the quota management, so I don't put a number here, but you certainly could have 500 megs as the setting that your IT department set, all the way up to whatever it is that they want to support and have storage capacity for. The real big one that we get, and I'm going to really kind of focus on it here for a second, is SkyDrive Pro is not SkyDrive Consumer. SkyDrive Consumer is a wonderful service. SkyDrive Pro is also a wonderful service. And you can think about it a number of different ways. SkyDrive Pro is where you put your work documents. It's where you store your company information in terms of draft documents and different timelines that you might be working on. When it comes to SkyDrive, that would be where you maybe put your the flyers for some garage sale that you might be having, and you want to send that out to your block lead so that they can review it. Might be where you put your photos and pictures of your family. And we draw the distinction, but to even be more clear, they are separate services. SkyDrive is managed and run by the Windows team, and it is a separate service than Office 365. SkyDrive Pro, of course, in Office 365, is managed more by the Office division, and of course, it's just regulated very differently in different data centers. So they are separate environments, and of course, if you have it on premises, then your SkyDrive Pro is where you put it. We do support cross browsers, and that'll be one of the links that I'll put in from resources, is what is our mobile matrix and our desktop matrix. But if you think about it, any modern browser is what the target for SharePoint is to support. And of course, SkyDrive Pro, being a part of SharePoint or SharePoint Online, or SharePoint Online, will give you that same cross-browser access. And now, since just a couple of weeks ago when we announced the SkyDrive Pro apps, we are now also cross-device, so not just browser-based, but also native client apps for Windows Phone, which comes native with the phone, in iOS, which works on iPhone and iPad, and of course for Windows 8, we have a new modern app that we just put into those different stores, so they're just available. But the last basis of SkyDrive Pro is the Pro part really means it's SharePoint. It's backed by SharePoint, which is our enterprise-grade content management offering. There's a lot that you can do in SharePoint that enables a very rich content management and lifecycle management of documents, the experience, the access. But that's just another way to think about SkyDrive Pro. Again, in comparison to SkyDrive Consumer, is really that SkyDrive that's backed by SharePoint. So hopefully that's a easy way to think about SkyDrive Pro. I know that there are some questions that are coming into the IM that I'll address just before I switch over to the demo, at least a few of them, and then certainly towards the end. I know that there's interest in what are we doing around Mac clients, and I'll certainly address that. So just a few things from a what do I do or feature perspective. This first view is SkyDrive Pro benefits for users. So whether this is you or on behalf of, you're looking to review SkyDrive Pro and make a choice on whether you go to SharePoint Online, whether you stay SharePoint on-premises, or maybe you're not yet a SharePoint customer or an Office 365 customer, and you're reviewing this, hey, my company needs this store, sync, and share capabilities backed by, you know, something that I can trust from accessibility and certainly from a compliance and security. This is the user view. They can do full text search. There's a wonderful new enterprise search in SharePoint, and it very much applies to SkyDrive Pro. You can enable workflows for review of content. You can have certain things expire, be approved in an automated fashion. There's a whole social side of SharePoint Online and SharePoint 2013 where you can like and follow content. And when you do that, it feeds into your newsfeed, and there's a lot of benefit for liking and following. The one that I'll show you in SkyDrive Pro is the concept of a follow document, and what that means, maybe documents stored in the team site, but accessible like it's your own content, but it's really somebody else's being managed somewhere else. You can rate documents, the accessibility side of things. Certainly SharePoint has always focused on the accessibility, and this I mean both in access wherever you are, but also access in terms of fidelity and visual and audible access where people might be using it who are either hearing impaired or visual impairment. We adhere to all of those constraints, and I believe that SharePoint has always targeted a AA rating, and SkyDrive Pro would be no different there. We, of course, integrate with Office. We have a great experience. You'll see that a lot in the demo, especially when you're using that from either the web or a desktop client. You could also co-author. No difference in SkyDrive Pro in terms of how you can co-author. In fact, we think this is where a lot of people are doing co-authoring because it is their own environment to work from, and certainly where they share from. And then finally, people can tag their content, and certainly one of the biggest offerings that we have, and I'll show you this a couple of different ways, is offline sync, so that you have access to view your content, and in some scenarios with some of the devices, a nice edit experience. So this is the end user, but we certainly don't forget the basic requirements that maybe a CIO or an IT decision maker may have in terms of, yes, this is sounds like good technology, but I don't want things to run rampant. I don't want to be able to lose my control over the environment and content that is being created for the company, not just for the individual. So certainly they want to enable the sharing of content, both internal and external. There's deep auditing, which means we have a new e-discovery offering in the 2013 products, so that translates to both on-premises and online in Office 365. And those are some real rich e-discovery scenarios for potentially also compliance and auditing. SkyDrive Pro would just be another component that enterprise e-discovery search center would be able to discover and potentially have to put a hold on. SkyDrive Pro would be able to adhere to that. We certainly connect to AD, so in terms of gal lookup, when you go to share, type somebody's name in, it's very, very easy to see who you're sharing with, or when you want to share, that it's an easy lookup so that it's an ease of use. You can allow or disallow sync, and I'll show that when we get to the admin side of the demo. But this is something you can do at the library level, or with PowerShell, you can do it at a site collection level. There's also retention policies. You know, if you put a document center together or content type policies for what happens to a piece of content once it's created, maybe a year later, you need to archive that or manage it in a different way. It needs to be deleted. Those all apply. You can do that in SkyDrive Pro. We also integrate with Lincoln Office. So this is something that from an IT perspective, you can enable this on premises. Obviously, you deploy Link. And then online, if you have the Link SKU or the full Office 365 suite, that's already done for you, but you can then manage how Link and SharePoint interact and have that rich presence information for those rich dialogues you can do during co-authoring, or certainly you can disable that. And then finally, you can do some things with metadata. We have a component of SharePoint called the Metadata Managed Metadata Service, MMS. And this is something that from an IT perspective, you can influence what taxonomy users make and create, and as they tag their content, and again, if they're tagging content or putting content into SkyDrive Pro, this might be a control input panel within the Office desktop client where you require certain pieces of information before a piece of content is uploaded, even in the SkyDrive Pro, or just by default enable people to tag, but with a taxonomy that's managed at the corporate level. So that's my pitch around the user and IT, and certainly a little bit more around the what you can do with SkyDrive Pro. The final thing that I wanted to show here before showing you a whole breadth of devices and, of course, some demos on my desktop here, is just it, when we talk about SharePoint Online and Office 365, that if you have SkyDrive Pro deployed in that environment, we are accredited across multiple standards that we comply to and that we certainly achieve and reapply for so that we can be compliant across all of these different security measures. And some of them are certainly industry specific. Some of them obviously are government oriented, and certainly some of them are just if you have a very, very good, safe, and functional data center, you should have these accreditations, and we're proud that we have these. We also maintain this and always reapply. This is not something that you get a checkbox once and forget about. You have to maintain, and there's always a governing body if you want to actually say these things publicly that you need to keep up on being compliant. So SkyDrive Pro, again, falls into that from a security perspective. So we feel we balance that user access and productivity with IT control and management, and then certainly security being a big part of that. So I'm going to switch over here in a second and show you a whole bunch of demos. I am going to be showing a little bit on the desktop and then a little bit on a webcam, so I'll be switching between the two. But let me take a second here and catch up on some of the questions that have been coming through, and then I'll switch over to do some demo. And Josh, I know that you've been answering a few. Maybe you can prompt me just for time's sake here until the end where I'll cover everything. Was there any burning questions beyond Mac, which I'll address in a second, that you can maybe help with here just to point out?
So far, I think we have most answered. A couple people on the Microsoft side chimed in. I think everything's pretty good so far.
Okay.
Yeah, we're just looking at the roadmap for. Okay, we're fine.
Yeah, I think the big question that I saw at least a couple times was what are we doing with Mac? And one of the demos that I'm going to do is to show you drag and drop. And it really is just from a desktop folder, drag and drop into a web browser. It could be any web browser. Certainly, it could be a Mac's Safari. And I've done this demo live. I've done it for a CIO and a CIO summit just to prove that it can be done. But what I'll show you is going to be on a PC, but of course we support the drag and drop from desktop. If you do a save as from backstage of Office, we support that. And we are working on planning and resourcing Mac client. We don't yet have a date to announce, but we're working on solidifying with the engineering team when we think we can RTM and publish or produce a Mac sync client. So we are committed to having that experience on Mac. We don't yet have a time frame to share, but certainly we'll be looking for a forum soon to be able to share out our target date from a roadmap perspective. So we're not quite there with Mac sync, but what I'll show you today that is Windows sync, which is the desktop sync, that is our target to achieve on Mac. And the last two questions I see here, just to reiterate the plans for the where you can turn on or off sync. With PowerShell, you can turn it off or on at the site collection level. And what I'll show you today is if you go into a specific document library, you can disable sync for a team site document library, just to kind of show you what that looks like, because SkyDrive Pro, the component, one of them that I'll show you, also allows you to take content on a Windows machine currently, either from your SkyDrive Pro to sync that and have an offline copy of all your content, or from a team site document library. The last question that I see here that I'll address is, can an individual essentially buy more storage, more than the 7 gigs by default that's available in SharePoint Online today? In SkyDrive Pro on-premises, your IT team can manage the size of your SkyDrive Pro folder. And in SharePoint Online and Office 365, Microsoft manages what that default is. In our previous release, we had a default of 500 megabytes. And this current release, what is live today, is currently a 7 gigabyte storage quota for SkyDrive Pro. And we are working soon to release where you can allocate additional storage. And that is something that would come from the tenant pooled storage. We'll have more to announce and more specifics on the how and when. Currently, you can already purchase additional storage, but in production right now, you cannot allocate more to an individual SkyDrive Pro folder. But that is something that we're working to address in the short term. And so look for more announcements a little bit in the future. I do see one more that's a pretty easy one to address, or I guess it's more of a clarification. SkyDrive Pro is now SharePoint Workspace and MySite. The only thing here, I heard this a number of times, SkyDrive Pro is not your entire MySite, or what we are calling this release, your personal site. Your personal site has four main components. It's got SkyDrive Pro, which is a big component. It's got your news feed, or if you move into Yammer, it would include Yammer. It also includes sites, so these are sites that you follow, sites that are assigned to you by IT, and then finally your About Me page. We think those four main components are different components of a personal site. So we don't think of it as a replacement to My Site, but if you were to compare 2010 to 2013, what used to be called My Documents is now called SkyDrive Pro, but what used to be called My Site, we focus phrasing that as your personal site. Okay, so I'll make sure that either verbally or at the end, I'll spend some time once everybody starts to go offline to answer those questions. If you stay on and I haven't addressed them verbally, I'll absolutely get to them in the IM window. Just leave your session open so that you're connected to the IM chat still so that I can answer your question. I'll put your name and then the answer if it wasn't addressed already. We've got a number of people on the call, and certainly ask your questions at any time. But let's switch over and just start to see a little bit about what is SkyDrive Pro. So I'm going to share out my entire desktop here and just get a little verbal confirmation from Josh that we can see here. Josh, if you can just let me know that it looks like some folks are, I just want to make sure everybody can see my desktop now. Okay, looks like a few folks can. Thank you. And certainly, if anybody, especially Josh, if you see that it looks like we've lost connection or you can't see anything, please let me know. So what you're seeing here is a demo tenant. This is my personal one that I use just for demoing. But certainly here at Microsoft, well, I also have my real Microsoft SkyDrive Pro hosted in SharePoint Online. So I currently have that 7 gigs of space that I'm using. But what you're looking at here is my demo tenant. And just to give you a sense of that, this is really in production SharePoint Online. This is just my tenant name. Dash my means this is my personal site. SharePoint.com. If I took off just this, this will take me to my personal site. And then what I really navigated to was this SkyDrive tab up here, which in Office 365 represents SkyDrive Pro. So a few things just to kind of orient you with the layout here in SkyDrive Pro, at least the web view, is I've got a number of folders and, of course, content that I've put up here. Not everything is an Office content. This is just a regular image. This was my only default folder the first time I showed up here, and it by default is what it says it is. It's shared with everyone, which means it's shared with everyone internally. If I did not enable external sharing, then I would not, that does not mean that I'm sharing it with the world. But certainly if I put content in the folder, you'll see over here this little icon, and as I hover over it, it says shared with some people, and it really means shared with anybody who also has access from my company in the same tenancy. And if I click on it, you'll actually see who it's shared with. You know, it's everyone except external users at this time. I'll do some sharing from here externally and show you what that looks like. But the two icons really that you'll see here is yes, it's being shared, or this lock icon, which means it's only being shared with me. And in fact, the experience when somebody navigates to my SkyDrive Pro, to access a document, I might have sent them a link to this folder or to a piece of content here. But if they started to navigate around and I hadn't given permissions for them to see anything, you know, then what they would see, they would not see any of these pieces of content with this lock icon. They physically wouldn't even see it. But if it's been shared with them, and if it's not been shared with them, even if it's been shared with other people, they're only going to see what they have permissions to view and access. So this is a real easy way for you to see which ones are made available to other people. You can click in to see who, so that you can understand who it's being shared with at all times. I mentioned the concept of follow documents. So also another part of SkyDrive Pro, we think this is the social side of documents. These are documents that I found in a number of different locations, and if you just kind of look at the URL here, you can see that this is from a totally different site. In my same tenancy, so a different site collection. Here's from a very different one. This one is from the company portal that I have in my demo environment. And I've just chosen to follow it, which means I can access it, but it's not being stored or managed by me. But certainly if I go back to my documents, my SkyDrive Pro, I'll be able to see all this content that I'm working with. So one of the first things that you're probably going to do with SkyDrive Pro, or if you're working on a team project, in the concept of me, the end user, I'm going to start a new document. And I'm just going to start a quick Word document. And you'll notice everything that I'm doing, I'm staying pretty much within context of my SkyDrive Pro and within the browser. This does not open up Office in this scenario. So I will say, hello, all my viewers, just so we know about this webcast today. And it's first going to take me to the Word web app. And I'll keep this really short because this is not necessarily to demo the web apps or some of the other components of SharePoint, but just to get a quick document created here. I'll do this hello world. And then we'll just insert a quick picture for it to be a little bit prettier to look at. And we'll do sharing. And that looks like a good one. Then I'll save this and go back to SkyDrive Pro, and you'll see that this is now a new document in my SkyDrive Pro that I might be working on by myself or certainly sharing with other people. And I'll do that real quickly here. And I'll share a number of things and then turn to the person that I've shared it with so you can see what that looks like. But if we look for the new file that I just created, here it is. So from here, I can choose to share, and I'm going to share with Katie J, who is an internal person in this tenant. And I'm also going to share with a Yahoo address so you can see external sharing. And I want both of these people to initially be able to just view. So from SkyDrive Pro, I can share this file, but enable somebody to only view it. And if I wanted to, because I'm working on just a specific document, I'm actually not going to require them to sign in. Katie Jordan probably has access to my tenancy. Jenny, Spo Jenny, doesn't necessarily have access. So I'm going to need to maybe first just provide a review only, but a real easy link to provide, which is called a guest link. So it's anonymous access. I am going to want to send an email invitation, and I'll show you what that looks like in Jenny's email here in a second. So I'll get a little toast up here in my SkyDrive Pro that I'm now sharing this via a guest link. And you can see that the icon switched from a lock to now shared with multiple people. And again, if I clicked into it, you'll see the people that already have access to it. And until the external person signs in, that you wouldn't see them here just yet. But once they access the document, or if I provide access to the whole folder, I could do that and I would see them. So let me show you a couple other ways that you can get content in. And I'm going to kind of minimize a few things that I have going on here. The first is just imagine a scenario where on the left-hand side is Outlook. And this is, again, Demo Marks Outlook. But I want to get content that's maybe been emailed as an attachment to me, and I want to start managing it or storing it in SkyDrive Pro. One really easy way to do that is to drag and drop. So the action that I'm doing here is I'm just going to click and then drag from Outlook directly into my SkyDrive Pro folder. And that will, it might be because I'm in a protected view. Hold on one second. Open up that. So I've got from my documents folder. Here is a file that I just want to drag and drop. There we go. From my desktop folder, File Explorer, drag and drop that into my SkyDrive Pro. Once it's in there, I can actually then put it into another folder and drag that around until I'm happy with where it's landed. Real simple drag and drop. And what I just showed you is also functional in on a Mac. So it's the same thing. If I were in File Explorer on Mac and then in the Safari browser, I could do that drag and drop just the same. Okay, the other thing I wanted to drag in here was a picture, just so you can see that we're not talking about just office documents. And then once that's in there, you'll see that this is just a picture in SkyDrive Pro. Okay, so I'm going to switch over and show you a few things, again, from a browser perspective, before we move to apps. And I want to now just kind of share tab over to my camera. And the first device that I'm going to show here, I'm going to move my microphone just so everybody can hear, is an iPad 2. And the first thing, hopefully this is coming through. Just a little bit behind and a little slow, so I'll kind of try to step through a little bit slower. But the first thing I'm bringing up here is another person's SkyDrive Pro. So everything that you'll see on iOS is in the persona of Zarinka. So this is Zarinka through the Safari browser on an iPad. And this is her SkyDrive Pro in a web format. So if I wanted to go in here and create a new document, this time I'm going to create an Excel workbook. I'm going to name it. I'm going to call it Zarinka Today. And again, same as you saw over on the Windows, this is now going to take me into the web app, but this is the Excel web app, where I can put in new content and type in whatever it is that I want to put in here as new content. When I go back to her SkyDrive Pro folder by just clicking on her name, you'll see that I have now this new Excel spreadsheet created all by touch, all in the web browser. And I do a little refresh. Hopefully we can get back to where we were. Oops, sorry. And then down at the bottom here, I'll just move a little bit closer. There you can see a net new piece of content, Excel spreadsheet, created solely on the iPad in and from SkyDrive Pro. But I'm going to hover over just here because I'll kind of refer to it a couple of times. But this whole concept of being able to create in the browser, the Office Web Apps team has been doing some phenomenal work to be both cross-browser and cross-device, both in big formats, so a large computer, all the way down to a small personal phone, something in a 4-inch range. But all these actions, especially the last one, which is kind of part of the game at the end, are all things that you will be able to do in pretty much any browser. And they just recently announced that they will be supporting Android soon. So the same actions that I just performed would be available on Android. And that's actually one of the things that I just wanted to show you here quickly. If I move iPad out of the way, since we're still talking about browsers, this is a Galaxy S4, so a relatively new Android device. And it's a little bit washed out because it's a white page. So I'll try to move it closer and see if we can navigate it down. But this is now signed in as the Mark persona. This is my SkyDrive Pro. And fairly soon, the team will be supporting so that you can navigate in here, view a document, and have that be a nice experience accessing content in your SkyDrive Pro. And you'll see the real basic experience right now is already enabling me to access a Word document. This was my demo flow that I have for today. But it is a file that's stored in my SkyDrive Pro folder that I am able to access and leverage through the Chrome mobile browser on Android. So we do already have a decent story, but what we're targeting is that full functioning Office Web Apps access. So that's pretty much browser. And those are some of the main things that I wanted to share with you. I do want to move over and just start talking about desktop sync and share with you another couple of ways that you can actually get content into SkyDrive Pro. So let me navigate back to here. And we'll go back to my SkyDrive Pro folder. I forgot to mention this here just from a visual perspective. But on the left here is my SkyDrive Pro folder. And it really should look the same as everything on the left is the same as everything on the right. And if I zoom in here, you'll actually be able to see that this is showing me that things are syncing and are in sync with my primary folder, which is that web-based SkyDrive Pro folder. But that little checkbox here just means that it's been syncing, it's syncing well. And if I go and create a new piece of content, one way to get something in is to put in File Explorer, go New, and sometimes I gotta minimize this because it gets in my way with actions. So if I go New, not working for me today. Let's see if I kill this guy. SkyDrive Pro. And then click New. All right, well, what I was going to show you is just a quick, dirty way to do new kind of that's embedded in Windows. I'm going to come back to that a little bit later. And then the last thing, if I opened up Word, and just started from the desktop, and we'll kind of create something that maybe is sort of fun here, that is an award. We'll create this, and we'll say $25 award, SkyDrive Pros, just so that we're creating something new here. And then what I'm going to do from the backstage is I'm going to do a save as. And you'll see here that I have access to my SkyDrive Pro folder, which is represented here by the SharePoint icon. And since my tenant name is Contoso, you'll see as I hover over here that it's actually got me signed in as the admin, which is my username, admin@splnk, the same as you see on the right-hand side. And I'm going to navigate to that Shared with Everyone folder and just save this as New Certificate. And what this is going to do is going to save this. Obviously, locally, if I was offline, or it's going to take me to do this where it's going to sync it, and it should appear here on the right-hand side if the demo gods are on my favor. And I believe some of the new things just came in. Here's the Android fun, new certificate. Let me do a little refresh here since it's maybe not synced up just yet. You can see here's the document that I created initially earlier. And where is that? New certificates. Oh, sorry, it's in a different, it's in within the folder, apologize. And here it is. This is the new document, new certificate. If I click in from my web view, you'll see the full fidelity of the template that I chose and with the little simple text that I put in here. And again, what you're viewing on the right-hand side is just the Word web app accessed from my SkyDrive Pro. I'm going to try this one more time because I'm a little stubborn, and then I'm going to move over to step in here. I'm going to move over to show you some of the new SkyDrive Pro apps that we have. So again, I'm going to switch and find my camera. And we'll go this time. I want to show you a few things on iPhone. And then I'll show you similar things on the Windows phone. And take me a second. I'm just going to kind of lessen the brightness just for a second. I think it'll be a little easier to see. Okay, so what you're looking at here is one way to create a new document from an iPhone that stores and is saved into your SkyDrive Pro folder. So from here, what you're looking at is the Office Mobile for iPhone, which has innate connection if you want and have SkyDrive Pro to be able to create documents, view documents, and certainly look at things that you've been working with recently. So what I'm going to go do in here is just to create a new Word document based on a template, and I'm going to just put in here good point so that we can kind of see this later. The capability matrix here certainly may be something to review offline. It really walks through a lot of the different things that I showed you. SkyDrive Pro on Windows 8, which I haven't showed you yet, but that was the last thing I was trying to get to show you. SkyDrive Pro for iOS, which I showed on iPhone, iPad, the Sync client, which really does all of that sync to File Explorer on Windows, and certainly what we talked about coming for Mac in the future. Certainly the browser through the web, we have access through a number of different browsers, both mobile and through the PC and the Mac. And then on Windows Phone, it's embedded. It's just a part of the Office Hub. And now, just 2 weeks ago, we announced and released Office Mobile for iPhone, which really looks like and acts like and gives you the same capabilities as we've had on Windows Phone for a while now via iPhone. But just walking through a number of the different capabilities here, I'll let you read this. I won't go through it all. You'll see just a few yes and no's whether the app supports it. But certainly from a breadth perspective, we offer it across devices, the access and the type of capabilities that you would expect to do in SkyDrive Pro. This is a view today, and as we're working on these apps in point releases and certainly full releases in the future, you can expect that we're really targeting to have parity across devices to be able to give you that access to SkyDrive Pro, to be able to work with your content, to be able to share, to be able to sync or selectively sync, to take the content with you while you're on the run. And certainly, this just gives you a breadth view with also some install links if you've got these devices and want to start to experience SkyDrive Pro in the web or beyond. You can go and on your device, click this, put this little quick link in from the device, and it'll take you right to the store. And then you can download, install, and certainly make sure you've got SharePoint on the back end or SharePoint Online for some of the apps so that you can have something to actually work with or against on the back end. I have a couple of things that I staged here as FAQs that I'll just put out again that you can review, not for me to walk through now, but if any of these came up, we've got a number of FAQs that we've put together in the deck just as more of a reminder. And then the remainder of the deck, just so you know what you get, is a lot of screenshots of what I demoed or mostly demoed so that you could see those. I am going to go in and I'm going to send out the game that I intended to play just to kind of get that going. And just as a reminder, this is if you want to play, this is something that will be in my Twitter feed. And it's actually an Excel survey that is available. I'll try one more time to get this primary machine back into this environment so that we can demo from it. Trying. Okay. So now Josh, can you make the person that I just signed in with a presenter?
Yeah, let me do that.
And unmute me. All right.
Okay.
Okay, Josh, so just one more time, can you hear me now?
Yep, loud and clear.
Okay, so apologies everybody that this is how it's gone. But the thing that I wanted to share out here, I'm just going to put out a quick tweet that'll showcase basically what's loaded up here. Is this this survey. So there's a link to this survey now, which is an anonymous link, which is managed in my SkyDrive Pro folder. But I'll ask if you want to play along. This is now in my Twitter feed. And you can't, it's not to take it here. You actually have to go on your machine and click the link from my Twitter feed. But what it really actually is I went in and created a new document. And on the back end from my SkyDrive Pro folder, I went new document and created a new Excel survey. And what it created here was this, file, which I'm not going to open up here because I don't want to show anybody's information if people are already filled it out and submitted. But to the end user, if you are filling out this survey that I created, you would see this in your browser. And hopefully I've covered all this in terms of being able to answer it. Make sure to put your email address in so that I can choose the first three people on the spreadsheet that I see that got all answers correct. I'm going to send them a gift certificate via their email address. From the container store, since we're talking about store, sync, and share, I thought it would be fun as a giveaway to give access for you to store stuff that maybe is going to be in your closet. So your work files in SkyDrive Pro and all of your storage in the garage, maybe in something from the container store. But again, in the Twitter feed, you'll see a link to this survey and hope that you can play along. But just to emphasize, the reason that I did it just for fun is this is being managed out of SkyDrive Pro, this particular survey that I can do by myself and give access to anybody anonymously to fill out. It's called an Excel survey. So a few things that I had done, I had sent out a couple of invites to Zarinka, from Zarinka and from myself to Spo Jenny. So this is what those look like, where I've given permission maybe to this document. I did this from the iPad. Here was where I wanted to invite her to view from a site, and then also something where she could access a particular document directly. And now I'm going to switch over and just show you those last couple things that I meant to show on the iPad, which is really the crux of everything, the new app that we've put out there. And then I really apologize for the time here. Bring back camera. And bring back the iPad. And just verify that you can see this. And hope that I'm still connected and that you can hear me. I know that I'm still connected in because I can see here. But what I'm in right now is the SkyDrive Pro app. And I'm in offline. That was the last thing that I showed. I'm gonna go back to my files. I'm gonna stay offline just for the sake of it. Probably will take a second for it to reconnect. But what I had done is I had gone into the file that I had created in this intro to document, and I turned off my wireless. And if I tried to access anything else on this iPad right now, you wouldn't be able to see. You'd see that I'm not connected to the internet. But if I go back to this offline folder, and here's that document that I had created and open, I want to open now offline, even though I don't have internet, and you can see that in the upper right hand next to the iPad, there's no internet connectivity. And I'm just going to go in and open that document, and I still have access to the content that I took with me offline. But again, from the SkyDrive Pro folder, I can access content in a connected state. I can selectively sync. And the way that I do that, I don't remember if you would have seen this, but this same document that is not accessible to me, I'd be able to take offline before I'm in a disconnected state and have it go with me. So that was, I hope, the last thing that I had showed you. And then just a few things that I had wanted to show you were just those proof points of content now showing up in different places, one being my SkyDrive Pro folder. You'll see everything here that's green is all new content that I've been creating across all these different devices. I use the Office web apps in my SkyDrive Pro folder through the Safari browser on an iPad. I created a new document on the Windows phone into my SkyDrive Pro folder. I created a new piece of content for Zarinka, and just to show you what her SkyDrive Pro folder looks like, the last thing I'll show you here so that I really don't waste your time is Zarinka's SkyDrive Pro folder signed in as Zarinka. You'll see here on a Chrome browser on a Windows machine, I'm viewing Zarinka's SkyDrive Pro folder, and you'll see some of the things that she created or some of the things that were shared with her. If she chose to follow things, she'd be able to get that content as well. So, Josh, I'm going to turn it back over to you. I am going to stop presenting and put up that last slide just for reference so that if people want to read through that matrix again, they can. But I'll turn it back over to you, and certainly greatly appreciate your